The dope sheet is kind of like the timeline on crack. It's also a motion editor and also a keyframe manipulation tool like the timeline. However, it allows for much, much more granular control and information about your keyframes. And it's particularly great at changing the timing of your animations. You can make an entire polished animation using just the dope sheet. So let's talk about it. We are once again in the default Blender scene for this tutorial. If you don't know how to get there, just press Ctrl plus N for new and then click on General right here. There's many ways you can access the dope sheet in Blender, and the fastest would actually be to click this little animation workspace at the top of the Blender window, like so. This has the dope sheet right here, the timeline right here, and two 3D viewports right here and here, which is just like a really, really nice setup to have for making animations in Blender. So if you want to quickly get into animating in Blender, this workspace is a great option to have. You can also access the dope sheet by changing the contents of any panel of your scene to the dope sheet. For example, I can click on this 3D viewport, click on dope sheet, and now our 3D viewport here is the dope sheet. But of course, we don't really want that, so we're going to go back to here and go to 3D viewport, like so. So just like on the timeline, if we press I for insert, then we click on location, rotation, and scale on our cube, you'll see that a keyframe is placed in our dope sheet. And if we go to frame 50 here, like so, then we press insert to insert another keyframe, and we'll do another location, rotation, and scale in this case. You can see that keyframes work the exact same way in the dope sheet as they do in the timeline. And I'm actually gonna move our cube forward here by pressing G, and then I'm gonna confirm that placement by pressing left click. I'm gonna rotate our cube pressing R, then I'm gonna scale our cube pressing S. I just realized my screencast keys are not working. Come on, there we go. And then I'm gonna confirm all that by pressing I once again and pressing location, rotation, and scale because I don't actually have auto key on right here. I'm gonna enable that just for the hell of it. And I actually want my animation to end in frame 50 here. So all I need to do that is with my mouse in the dope sheet, I can press P, then I can do a box selection holding left click that starts on frame 1 and ends on frame 50, just where exactly where we placed our keyframes. So if I release that and then press space to play back our animation, ooh, that's a lot of rotation. But yeah, it's playing back exactly as we'd want it to, where it's ending on that final keyframe now. So if I actually turn this off by disabling the preview range, like so, you can see that it would just keep going and there'd be a lot of dead space at the end of it, which we don't want. So we're gonna click that once more to enable that. And I'm gonna pause my animation by pressing spacebar. So just like the timeline, the dope sheet displays keyframes and shows objects' animatable properties right next to the object name on the left side here. To expand our view here, there's this little arrow icon that we can click, and that will expand our view of all the keyframes we just placed. So remember, we pressed I to insert location, rotation, and scale, right? So if we actually look in the dope sheet here, we can see all of our location keyframes, all of our rotation keyframes, and we can't actually see all of our scale keyframes, but we can just mouse down with our mouse. So long as we're in this part of the dope sheet, we can mouse down to see the remainder of the scale keyframes that we just placed. To modify any of these keyframes, all you need to do is click on one. For example, we'll do the Y location, press G, then move it around. And as you can see, we are now modifying just the Y location on our cube here. And if I press right click, I will cancel that. And if I press G and then left click, I will confirm it, just like the timeline. Again, please watch the last video if you've not seen it yet, because it explains a lot of this in depth. I'm gonna undo that by pressing Ctrl plus Z. And now let's say I actually wanna select all these keyframes in this row, right? I wanna change the timing of all of them at the same time. Well, to do that, there's actually a section on our timeline here, or excuse me, our dope sheet here called Summary, which lets us do that, but we can't actually see it right now. And that's because it's at the top of our dope sheet, and it can be really annoying because it's kind of hard to tell that this isn't actually the top of the dope sheet and we're not seeing everything here. And there's a few ways to fix that. One is to scroll up using this little scroll wheel at the top, and we can see right now that the summary is right there. You can also use middle mouse button to scroll around on your dope sheet, or you can press the home button, which is the button on your keyboard above the arrow key, so the home button. That kind of frames all of your keyframes in the dope sheet in a really nice way. So now if I click on this keyframe in the summary section and press G, we're gonna be changing all of our keyframes at the same time in this row. So I'm going to undo that placement that I just did by pressing Control plus C, which was on the exact same keyframe. So I don't know why I did that. But you can also do the exact same thing by holding Alt and then left clicking anywhere on this row of keyframes. So if you want to select an entire row of keyframes at the exact same time, press Alt, then left click in the dope sheet. And now if I press G here, we're moving around like so. I'll confirm that placement by pressing left mouse on frame zero. And again, just like the timeline, you can manipulate keyframes in the dope sheet the exact same way. So I'm grabbing keyframes with left mouse button here. I'm moving keyframes with G. I'm confirming placements with left mouse button. I'm undoing placements with Control plus Z. And you can also copy and paste keyframes. So if I have this, say, for example, I wanted to copy and paste this final keyframe we made on frame 50, I will press left mouse button to highlight it. Then I will press Control plus Z. Excuse me, I'll press Control plus C to copy it. And then if I wanted this on frame 20, for example, I will move my playhead to frame 20 and then press Control plus V, which is paste. So Control plus C is copy and Control plus V is paste. So now if we play back our animation, it gets to that final frame really quickly. So I'm going to press pause once more and undo that by pressing Control plus C. You might have also noticed that in the dope sheet, there's a series of checkboxes. And if we play back our animation and click this checkbox, we'll see that it actually stops because this checkbox essentially disables animation either on an entire object or an animation channel. So if I uncheck all the rotation keyframes, for example, you'll see that our cube is no longer rotating because that just disables all the animation in those channels, which can be really handy sometimes. I'll enable all those by clicking on the checkbox on them once again. And this little lock icon kind of does exactly what you'd expect it to do. If I click on this lock and then try to move my keyframes, Blender doesn't let me. So the lock icon just either locks an entire object or a specific animation channel so you can't like mess with it accidentally for whatever reason. I'll unlock that again by clicking on the lock icon. One of the most exciting parts of the dope sheet that I swear to God I didn't even know was a thing until like yesterday when I was doing research for this video, it's under view. So if we click on view and go to show sliders, it's right there. Show sliders, very important. If we click on that, you will see that, it's kind of hard to see what we're looking at here because things are getting overlapped. So I'm going to hold left mouse button when my mouse turns into that like arrow icon shape, and I'll hold left mouse and drag it out so this whole section's a little bit bigger and easier to read. And by enabling that option, we can now see in real time all of the values on every single animation channel we have right here. But say on frame 25, and I'm going to pause our animation reversing space. Say in frame 25, we want our cube to like jump. So I don't know why you'd want that, but let's, for the sake of argument, let's do that. So we're going to go to Z location. And then we're just going to hold left mouse button on that and drag our mouse to the right. Now, if we play back our animation, you can see that our cube does a little bounce like that. And that's so amazingly useful because it means that you can do all the animating you'd ever need to do on an animation just in this single panel. Because normally you'd have to go like here, which is like the object data properties, right? Yeah, object properties. You'd have to go to this panel, which is really annoying and like far away. But this way you can do absolutely everything in like the exact same place, which is just an amazing, amazing time save. So I highly recommend you check that option out. There's also this little option right here at the top of the dope sheet called only show selected. So if I deselect my cube by just left clicking in any of this negative space in our 3D viewport, then I click on this option. You can now see that we will see all the animation channels of our cube, even though it is not an actively selected object in our viewport. So if I click on this again, you'll see that the cube disappears and will only reappear if I click on it and it's my active selection. There's also a handy option next to this called Show Hidden, which essentially views channels and objects that are hidden in your scene. So if you had another cube here, for example, and it was hidden, you would be able to see its animation channels if it was selected or if you had only show selected turned off. You can also make channel groups in the dope sheet. So if I click on X location, for example, on my cube here, then I shift click Y location in Z location, then pressed Control plus G, and then I can name this group, for example, location, because it's just the location keyframes on my object, then press enter. You'll now see that right here, we have a location group on our cube. So we can expand this just like we expanded our object transforms right here. We can expand this by pressing this little arrow icon, then scroll down. We'll see all of our location channels right here, which can be nice because you can press B then box select all of those. And it can just be a nice way to like quickly organize and select things in the dope sheet. And say, for example, you want to access the summary section at the top of the dope sheet or just get a bird's eye view of everything going on in your dope sheet, you can press the home button on your keyboard to view everything at once. And something really neat that is so useful, and I only discovered this recently, I wish I had known it sooner, is that you can press Control plus Tab to instantly switch to this editor, which is the graph editor. This is what we're going to talk about in the next video, and it's crucial for when you're at the polishing stages of your animation and you really want to refine things and take things to the next level visually in your animation. So be sure to check out that video right after this one, and check out my Patreon to get access to an exclusive Discord community and a heck of a lot more. I'll see you in the next one. Congratulations on finishing this tutorial. It might feel like a small step, but you're now one step closer to animation mastery. And if you want access to an exclusive Discord community, exclusive rewards, and help ensure that I can keep making tutorials for you just like this one, check out my Patreon. Link is in the description below.